What's going on, everyone? Dougie here. Welcome to Chateau Elan. This is one of the premier public courses. It's sort of like a destination. They have a winery on site, two 18-hole courses, and this is my first visit. And I'm already impressed by the practice facility, the look of the course conditions, so I'm excited to bring you along. If you're new to the channel, as always, go ahead and hit that red subscribe button. Give the video a thumbs up if you enjoy it, and let's roll over to the first tee. Welcome to Chateau Elan. Hole number one is a 380-yard par four from the tips back here, the silver tees. Pretty straight away, it looks like I'm just aiming for that 150 stake. I have a 3-iron, just want to get in play here. Nice introduction hole to the course. Might have actually hit it too far with a 3-iron. It's getting pretty hot, fairways are firmer. Now I have about 110 yards left. So I think that was about a 270-yard 3-iron because of the rollout. A little bit further than I wanted to. I now have a downhill lie. And look at that back pin position. Wow. Immediately I'm impressed. I like this course already. Good conditions. Green's looking pretty pure. Bunkers look nice. Everything looks nice. And there's my ball. So we gotta go up a ridge and we gotta lag this one close. I mean, are you kidding me? Have you ever seen the start of a course walk quite like that? I mean, I've not. I felt like I gave that the biggest backstroke I could even imagine, and I smacked that ball, and it was just tracking the whole way, found the bottom of the cup. I mean, are you kidding me? Starting off with a birdie from that far? Oh my gosh, like, wow. So what a start to the vlog here at Chateau Elan. Maybe I should just stop right there, call it a day, go home, one under par. But no, we're gonna go on to hole number two. This is hole number two here. I don't even know what I'm looking at. You need to lay it up there, and then it looks like there's water and there's a creek. I don't know how far it is to the creek, so I'm just gonna play it safe. Maybe hit a 7-iron, just lay it way back. Try to play for position. We can't even quite see the hole, but we gotta be in play. So we hit a great shot, we're in great shape, but it looks like I could have probably hit a 5-iron. Hit a 7, just wanted to make sure that we kept it short of the water hazard, but I probably have a long approach shot in. First time out here, we're just giving it a test drive, see how it goes. Learning about this course, but I love this course already, so might have to come back. They do have another 18-hole course too. I believe it's called the Woodlands. This is the Chateau course at Chateau Elan. So we have about 205 yards in, a slight breeze into us. Again, we could have laid it up closer, but wanted to play it safe on this hole here. Let's give you a little view of the green. There's the pin over there. 205 yards into the wind. Got to club up a little bit here. Hitting with a 5-iron from 205 yards into the wind. So here we are. We almost went through the green. We got right at the back of the green here. Probably just took too much club. I'm hitting the ball far right now and not adjusting to these yardages. So that's okay though. We got a long putt again. Speed here is key. Two putt is our goal.
There's a bogey.
Tough to see the 3-putt there. Hit a great lag putt from that distance. And then on the short putt there, I saw it straight and I think it might've just moved a little bit. I'm not sure if I just pulled it a hair or not, but it's okay, it happens. And Gotta just stick to what I'm doing right. I'm hitting the ball well, striking it well. Or even par through two holes. We got a lot of golf ahead of us. So let's be encouraged going to the next tee. This is the third hole of par five, measuring 547. I'm just gonna hit a five iron. Just play for the fairway there. Looks like it's a double dog leg. So tough to get home in two. We're just gonna lay it back with a five iron. Well, unfortunately, everything's so hot and dry, I think I rolled into the hazard. So just gonna take a drop here, get it back into play. Now I'm hitting three. Got about 125 here. You know that feeling when you grab an iron off the tee because you're afraid of trouble, you're afraid to go for it, and then you still go out of bounds? Yeah, not fun on the last hole. Tried to play smart and just hit a draw, and I was aimed for a fade off the tee. So anyway, good two putt, got a bogey, so we're back to one over par here, or I would say we are at one over par here after I started one under, so it's time to make a move here. Beautiful looking par four ahead of us. About a 420 yard par four here. We got driver, but it looks pretty narrow on the left. I think it opens up past that, but it looks like right is your safe bailout area if you need one. So looking at this hole from this vantage point, look how thin this fairway is. I mean, I grabbed driver thinking I just laid up and I hit it out of bounds, but my instinct was telling me just hit like a three wood or three iron. I mean, there's no room if you hit driver. Like, there's trouble left, there's trouble right, and I think I flew right into these trees. So unfortunately, probably another penalty stroke. It is our lucky day. I was just taking a walk just to see, maybe I got lucky. A lot of tree branches over here. And look what I found in the middle of the rough here, great spot. Yep, that's us. You know, we play a red line on our ball. So fortunately, we got a break here. Let's try to capitalize on that big break. So we literally went through about five tree branches, didn't catch any wood, and we landed on the low side of the pin here. Uphill putt for birdie. Let's go. .442 yard par four. I can't tell if our tees are up because we're right behind the gold. So this might be playing shorter. It looks like there may be a further back tee box. So it might be shorter than 442 here. Pretty much straightaway par four. Looks like everything is right in front of us. Just want to be in the center of the fairway. No such luck on this hole. I heard wood, but as you can see, it's pretty thick over here. So just dropped one here. Now we're kind of blocked out by these trees. The green is under the trees. So now we're gonna just try to punch it under the trees and really just try to play smart from here on out. So this is where we ended up. We almost got it to the green, which I'm pretty proud of. And now I'm gonna chip this one. Too much to putt through, I think. Probably play a little bump and run with the pitching wedge. cannot tell you what a clutch putt that was. I can't express enough what that does for my momentum, my mojo. I mean, after hitting two errant tee shots in a row, actually three in a row, just to be able to scramble and get out of there with bogey, absolutely critical. So now it's just a matter of getting the ball and play off the tee, going from there. But man, that felt good. This is hole number six. The silver tees are up. Looks like the tips could be all the way up back there. Would be a fun view from there, but I'll take it. 160, looks pretty gettable. Pin is up. This is a hole that we can strike on. So that was one of the biggest pulls with the pitching wedge I've ever hit. I'm changing my swing, trying to hit a little bit of a cut there, and I aimed left and I actually tugged it even further left. I was mad, so I hit a second shot, and I'm sure you can guess, you know, player B steps up, no pressure, easy shot, but let me just show you where my second shot went. So that's my second shot right there. Obviously no pressure, it's a lot easier to hit, but I mean, are you kidding me? That's where the second ball went, which just makes my first shot hurt even more. We're way left. We got to get up and down here. We got a 420 yard par four. I can't tell how far that second creek is. I can see the 150 stake out there, but I don't know how much room there is. Probably have about 175 here. Missed the fairway left, but no problem. Got a good lie in the rough. And pin sitting on the left side. That was a crazy shot. The ball landed about 5 feet left of the pin. Sorry, the ball bounced 5 feet left of the pin, hopped about 15 feet right. So I ended up like getting pushed all the way to the right side of the green, and it looked like I was gonna be all over that flag. I must have just caught a ridge there. Great swing nonetheless, but that was just crazy bounce. So here's a little view of this green. I landed, I mean, somewhere right in here, and I thought it was gonna bounce forwards towards the pin. It bounced, and that's where our ball is. So pretty crazy spot there. I just needed to carry it probably another 10 feet to get a flat bounce and lie. But we still got a birdie putt. Look at this par three. The card says 200, but tees look up again. We got 185 playing slightly downhill. Beautiful houses in the backdrop here. Pins look in front. I got a 7-iron. Let's just smooth one up there on the green. Give ourselves a look at bird. So this is the type of course I'm playing right here. I'm just showing off a little bit of the conditions. I haven't done too many panoramic shots. You can see obviously some of the houses in the backdrop are pretty stunning, including that one right there. But wow, I mean, I'm so impressed by the conditioning of this course. The greens are pure. My ball went all the way to the back of the green there. 7-iron was just way too much club. So we got a long lag putt coming up. It is a toasty day out here in Georgia. Obviously there, wrong club off the tee, put myself on the back of the green, had a really long putt. It was all downhill and I didn't really play much for that and paid for the penalty there. So not great, but you know what? It happens. It happens, speed control. We got a beautiful par five here. This is number 9, closing off the vlog. Let's just grab the big stick, give it a rip, see if we can get home in 2, see if we can end with the birdie. We got a runaway cart. The brake's been giving me problems all day. So that's a problem. So we're not getting home in 2. Missed the fairway, did not hit it very well. Now we're just playing for position. Probably gonna take a pitching wedge or something like that over these trees. Get back in the fairway. Still a birdie hole though. Sitting in great position here. Can't see a lot of the green. I know I'm 150, but I can't tell what's around the green, so I'm just gonna trust 150 and hit it. So I was a little left of my target, but all things considered, blind shot, distance control was good. Why don't we see if we can try to finish the day like we started it, with a birdie. Let's give this a run. So as you can see, I'm baking out here in the sun. Welcome to Georgia. But that's Chateau Elan for you. I hope you enjoyed seeing the Chateau course. I know they have another 18-hole course. We showed you the front 9. Started off with an absolute bang. That was a bomb. Started 1 under and then kind of just plotted our way. Didn't keep the ball in the fairway. Didn't keep it out of trouble like I wanted to. Short game, you know, at times was good and at times wasn't great, but that's gonna wrap it up there. Don't know what I shot. Guessing something like a 4 over par would be my guess. But hope you enjoyed watching this video, seeing a new course around the Atlanta area. Again, if you're new to the channel, go ahead and hit that red subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the next one. Dougie here.